described and captioned media program. In the classroom and online, dcmp.org. Film Ideas Incorporated presents The 1900s.
America's West Coast suffered earthquakes. The first modern taste of these natural forces destroyed a metropolis, San Francisco. Life was built on shaky foundations. San Francisco today is a flourishing metropolis, but at the turn of the century, it was still a growing city. Big names enhanced San Francisco's reputation. In April 1906, Enrico Caruso, the famous tenor of the Old Continent, came to visit the young city.
Caruso must have been impressive. He came in, stayed at the Palace Hotel, and charmed the city.
After tense anticipation, Caruso was booked. On the evening before the catastrophe, 17th of April 1906, he sang in the opera Carmen at the Metropolis. After the fabulous evening, the city slowly awoke. The people went about their daily routine. Raffaello Paolinelli was the owner of a successful greengrocery. His daughter Cora, who was born at the turn of the century, was 6 years old at the time.
My father went down to the market to buy his vegetables, and he went down real early that morning. My mother said, I don't know why he went so early, but he said he needed so many things.
At 5:12 a.m., the earth shook.
I can remember the house shaking violently, my bed. It went wheeling across the room, I remember that. I remember my mother crying out from her room, saying, oh, this is the end of the world.
This was the largest earthquake which had ever struck a modern city. The nightmare lasted for 48 seconds.
Oh, I was scared to death. Everybody was scared. We kept thinking it's going to come back, you know, we're going to have another one.
The city awoke at dawn to piles of ruins. Only a skeleton remained of the great town hall. The force of the earthquake measured 7.9 on the Richter scale. The destruction was equal to the force of 6 million tons of dynamite.
The Described and Captioned Media Program provides services designed to benefit students who are blind, visually impaired, deaf, hard of hearing, and deaf-blind. These services include a library of free loan described and captioned educational media, a clearinghouse of information related to educational media access, a gateway to internet resources related to accessibility, and a center for training and evaluation of any service provider desiring to appear on the DCMP's approved lists of description and captioning service providers. There are no user registration or service fees. Visit the DCMP at dcmp.org. The DCMP is funded by the U.S. Department of Education and administered by the National Association of the Deaf.